الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على خاتم الأنبياء أشرف المرسلين. This is a video a lot of people have been asking for, and I think it's actually a very important subject, and that is effective note taking. As a student of knowledge, it's very, very important that you're able to retrieve the knowledge that you get. A lot of people go to durus and they, alhamdulillah, finish the durus, and then they retain a part of it and most of it they lose. And then they say, oh yeah, I studied this book, I studied that book, but then what do you remember from it, right? Now some tulab ilm are like, mashallah, blessed, they memorize everything. Everything they hear, it just sits in their memory. 10 years later, you can ask them and they'll tell you exactly. But those are far and few between. I'm not one of them. So I love taking good notes and I love going back to my notes. Many of the books that I took notes when I was studying in the late 90s or in 2004 or so on, I go back to those notes and I benefit from them. Because I don't remember everything from that dars, but I do go back and see what's written. But the problem gets to be is keeping those notes. A lot of people are fans of just taking your notes online, but people lose notes. Hardly anybody ever goes to the cloud and gets an old document and goes through it. I mean, I don't do it. So what I had, a lot of good notepads, and I would take good notes in them. But then the problem is lugging those around, especially when you go overseas to study, you have tons of notepads. These, for example, are from some of my classes. So what I did is I ripped out the pages that were important and kind of brought those back with me and stapled them and kept them with me as notes. But then they get lost. They get separated from the book itself. So what I want to focus on today is note-taking in the book. Now, not everybody can take notes in the book during a dars, meaning when the sheikh is teaching or you're listening to a dars on YouTube or whatever, for you to be able to take nice, clean notes may not be your skill. So you can take those notes in a notepad outside of the book and then go back and transfer those notes onto the book. In order to do that, a few very important, and this is number one, okay? Make a fahras or a table of contents for yourself. Table of contents usually come in the back of Arabic books. I'll give you an example here, inshallah. This is my copy of Bulugh. I have a few different prints, but this is the one I take my notes in. In the back, you will find a table of contents, right? What's in it, what volume, what page number, depending on how many volumes it is. This even has like a table of contents for every hadith, subject, narrator, so on and so on, right? The one we usually use is the subjects, right? By the mawdu' or the subject, mawdu'at. What I do is usually in the end, you will have a couple of blank pages. I make my own table of contents because there may be some issue that I find very important. And then if I want to come back, I don't want to be going through all of the table of contents to try to find that issue again. I make my own. I take a ruler, make the line, put the name, put the page number. That way, I know those things are important to me. Maybe they're important to my community. Maybe they're issues that I know that I'll need to come back to. And that way I can quickly glance my own handwritten table of contents in the back. And that's why the publishers usually leave blank papers in the back for you to be able to do those. So that's the first thing. Make your own table of contents in the back with things that are important to you. Especially in books like Sharh al-Mumti' of Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen. It's 15 volumes, excellent print. They've done a really detailed job of the table of contents, but it's really hard to find something because it's so detailed. So in that way, you make your own. It's easy for you to get to. You can do it with each volume. If it's more than one volume, if it's one volume, then you just do it in the back of the book. That's the first point. Second, try to get prints. Like this is a print of Kitab al-Tawheed of Sheikh al-Islam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. This is Maktaba Dar al-Tawheed. In cooperation with Maktaba Tawba, they printed this together. And this is Silsila Mutun Talibat al-Ilm. Yani, this is the Silsila, which is a series of Mutun for seeking of knowledge. And what they did is they gave you room for notes. So this is a really good print. If you can get whatever book you're studying, if you can get a print like this that gives you actual lines, you can clearly, like these ones I wrote during the dars, I was able to write them out. But what I like to do is color coordinate my notes. And this is very important. This is number two, color coordinate your notes. I'm not saying this has to be one color, something like a shari'i hukum or something. But what I'll do is, okay, so for example here, the ahadith, I put them in blue. That's just for myself. It just makes it easier when I come back to my notes to know what I'm doing, right? The aqwal of ulama, I put in green. Those things that I found to be of great importance, I put in red. And the ayat of Quran, I put in this dark orangish color. Just doesn't really matter. But the point there being that I can color coordinate my notes, which makes it easier for me to teach from. And it makes it easier for me to read through and understand when I come back to my durus or my notes, maybe 10, 15 years later, which I have. So, I mean, there's not like a fictional scenario. Having said that, the problem you will get to face is if you don't have a print like this, which has room for notes, then sometimes to consolidate your notes onto the page gets to be very difficult. So always try to find prints of the book that if it's not like that, where they actually have a lot of room, they should just have blank spaces so you can use that for your notes. So this is a print, and I've recommended this print a few times. Zad al-Mustaqni' with the tahqiq of Sheikh Abdul Mohsin ibn Muhammad al-Qasim, one of the imma of Masjid al-Nabwi. And this print of Zad al-Mustaqni', this is the book Zad al-Mustaqni'. I have two copies of the same print. One is blank. I just got it in my last trip. So you can see the blank spaces. You see this blank area? And the same page, this is page 33, I'm going to show you from the one that I used for teaching and originally for my studies and then for teaching. This is the same page. But now you see what I've done is all that blank space, I've used it, page 33, to put my notes. And here what I've done, and as you can see, I've used different colors. I'm sure you can tell from the video, inshallah, is again, the ahadith are in blue. The highlighter is used a lot to make sure that I understand and I'm able to convey the emphasis on different things. Usul, this is a fiqh book. So here, usul and qawaid are in this purplish color. Ayat in a different color. The takhrij of the ahadith is in like an orangish color. And again, per book and per series, I'll switch up colors. But then I'll stick to those colors throughout that series as kind of a thing for your own brain to be able to process faster and easier. So you use that area to write notes. And again, if you're unable to do that when you're sitting in the dars, take your notes externally and then transfer them onto the book. This way, as long as you have the book, you have your notes, right? Some people will scan them and PDF them and keep them if you want to do all that. But otherwise, this is a great way. Now, some of the books, like books of hadith, it's a little bit different because here you're going to be looking at a lot of discussion of narrators. This is my copy of Bulugh. Here, one of the things I did was I used a lot of pencil, right? Why? Because I discussed each narrator and their hukam, like what was the ruling upon them, whether they are dabit or yani adil or some weak or strong or precise in their memory or whatever. So I used a lot of pencil because what I did, I took the notes first and then I went back into the books of Jarh wa Ta'dil, the books of biographies, rechecked all that and then erased and then finalized my notes again. So a good mechanical pencil is your good friend. Never forget that. Now, mechanical pencils or using pencils is great because you can erase them, you can go through them. Using pens, which I do like, especially when I'm using different colors, gets to be a little tricky because your notes will bleed. So I'm going to give you some pointers. And again, this is not sponsored by anybody. I don't get any free product or anything. I love fountain pens. Personally, if you know me, this is one of my favorite that I'm using right now. Another one that I'm using currently. Fountain pens write beautifully. I love them for my note taking, but I do not suggest them for taking notes on books. One, they bleed. Secondly, they write heavy, so even if they don't bleed, you'll see it on the other side of the paper. And that's that way, if you take your notes on the back, then it's gonna look messy, you won't be able to read your notes. So for writing in books, I'm gonna suggest a couple of pens. As you can see from my notes, I have a lot of different colors and things. I use I'm going to give you three suggestions, inshallah. One are these Sharpies. Now, I love Sharpies, but they always bleed. But there is a new type of Sharpie, and you can look this up, which is the bleed-proof, smear-proof Sharpies. They're very thin. They're not like the big marker Sharpies. They're thin. The great thing about them, they don't bleed through and they don't smear. So, great option for taking notes are these bleed-proof or bleeding-resistant, smear-proof Sharpies. Another great option is the Sharpie S-Gel. Gel pens are really good to write with. They write really well, but they smear very easily and they would bleed. So they came up with this S-Gel pen. And again, I'm not sponsored by any of these, but it writes really beautifully. It does not smear and does not bleed. The last option I'm gonna present here is a Pilot pen. And this is really cool because it looks like one of the little kid pens, but it's actually a really good pen. It's a Pilot Dr. Grip 4+1. It has a gray tab for black ink, has a blue, has a green, has a red. So when you're going through, you don't have to carry four or five pens. You can have one of these. And the front one actually becomes a mechanical pencil. So it has a mechanical pencil, has a eraser. So it's everything, especially when you're traveling. If you're going to be traveling to seek knowledge and you don't want to carry a box of pens like I do, just take this. It has four colors, so you can change up the colors, and a mechanical pencil for you to be able to take your pencil notes. More notes or beneficial trips. Post-its. Stickies, post-its should be your best friend. I have tons of them, plenty of them. Those of you that have watched our Bible debate videos know that I use a lot of these. They're really beneficial. I use different ones for different books. Some of these thicker plastic ones for books that I know that I'm going to want to review and go back to years and years from now. Sometimes I use thinner ones just kind of temporarily because I'm putting them in for a point that I know I may not need later. But using post-its is really a great idea. I always mark them. So here you can see they're all marked so that I can, when I come back, I can just quickly browse through these and find what I'm looking for. Especially when you read a lot and you have a lot of books that you've studied, you want to be able to get to that that reference quickly. This is a great way. I know kids may pull them off or something sometimes. That's why you still need that fahras in the back, your own table of contents. The last thing that I'm going to really suggest here are highlighters. Highlighters are your best friend. I love highlighters, right? Why? And I have different colored highlighters, So we have yellow, which is standard, but I also have sometimes red, green, and blue, and so on. Yellow is the one I use usually, but sometimes you want a different one because you want to make sure that you can highlight different aspects of a book. Why are highlighters so important? Because you're going through a book, especially bigger books, and you're going through pages and pages, but there may be one line that's really important. You highlight that out. When you come back to check on your notes, you look for that one line and you got what you need. Exactly what's needed. So, highlighters, post-its, good pens, a good mechanical pencil. These things are all useful, but how you take your notes is very important. Making your table of contents, using different colors for hadith, for ayat, for aqwal of ulama. These kinds of things come in very handy. For example, I have a book. See if I can find it here. These are mutun for the talib ilm, right? So this is a new one I just got, alhamdulillah. But I had one already. It's a collection of mutun. So now it's kind of difficult because I went through many of these mutun and I don't know sometimes where that matan begins and ends, that text. So what I did is I used stickies for each matan. And when I did something cool, I color coordinated them by the madhab in fiqh of that muallif, that author. So here, for example, green, let me just make sure. Yes. Green is for Hanbali ulema. Yellow is for Shafi'i ulema. And orange is for Hanafi ulema. And pink was used for Maliki ulema. Just to give them. And it's kind of cool. It kind of lets me see how the madhahib had an influence on the mutun that everybody studies. And these are general mutun, not just fiqh mutun or aqidah mutun or so on. And then, alhamdulillah, I made my own table of contents in the back for mutun that I had personally studied so I can get to those faster. And I highlight things throughout it, so it becomes very practical for me to go back and retrieve my notes. I hope from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that this will be a benefit for all the tulab ilm to be more precise in their studies and be able to recall that knowledge in a way that is beneficial for them for the rest of their lives. وَجَزَاكُمُ اللَّهُ خَيْرًا